Is this your card?
No!
The one trick pony strikes again!
Oh my!
Nathan, Rodrigo, and Scott.
What's up?
To my magic show, one trick only. I am
brilliant.
One trick pony.
Yes, the one trick pony's in the house.
I'm here for one trick only. It shall be a card trick. And Scott, I want to direct my first question at you. What's your favorite number?
7.
Why?
Always has been, since I was a kid.
Does it mean anything to you? Something to do with the age 10, maybe?
No.
Well, let me tell you, my favorite number is 21. A pretty special year for me, my 21st birthday. I went to travel the world for the very first time. I went to Vancouver, and that is where I saw this trick by a street magician. And also, why I'm going to do this trick with 21 cards. So, to start, I have one pack of cards here. I'm going to shuffle it up just to begin, just to prove that there is nothing wrong with this deck of cards and there's no way I could have planted any cards. So now, we're going to count out the 21 cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 20, 21. I'm going to leave the rest of the deck on the ground. Now, because we're in the middle of a global pandemic, you can't pick the card in person, Scott. So I'm going to go up to the camera, I'm going to spread the cards out, and what I'm going to do is, I'm going to run my fingers across the cards back and forward. You tell me when to stop when you're happy with the card, okay?
Stop.
Okay. So I'm going to pull this card out, and you are all going to look at the card. Can you see that card?
Yeah.
Rodrigo, Nathan, you can see the card?
Yes, indeed.
You've taken a mental note of this card. I'm going to put this back in the pile, smooth as I like. I'm going to close it up here. And to prove I have no idea what the card is, I'm just going to shuffle them again to prove that card is now lost in the pack. Now I'm going to invite my beautiful assistant, producer Callum, on stage. My second camera, because it's very important that you keep an eye on where your card is. There's three beautiful men in front of me in the crowd, so we're going to do this three times. We're going to place the cards in piles of seven, three piles of seven, and you're each going to get a go at keeping an eye on your card. All you got to do is tell me which pile your card is in. Is that clear?
Yep.
Yeah.
Scott, you're going to go first because you are the fully charged guest. Keep an eye on where your card is and remember which pile it is in. I will begin. Three. I'll count them out. 1, 2, 3. Group 1, 2, 3. Group 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. So count, you pull the card away. Which group was it in? Was it in group 1, 2, or 3?
Group 1.
Group 1, this one. Are we both happy with this, Nathan, Rodrigo? That it was in group 1.
Yep.
Are we sure? Perfect. Okay, Rodrigo, the professional in here, you are going to go next. So, Callum, I'm going to invite you back again. This time I'm going to look away to make sure that there is no way that I will know which card it is. Group 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Rodrigo, my professional, which group was it in?
I would say group number 1. Did I miss, guys? Is that one right? Yeah, right. One.
Group one. Group
number one. So this one here. We're fully sure.
Yes, 100%. Yeah.
Okay. Hopefully that is correct. Unless I've got this completely wrong. For the final time, Nathan O'Reilly. Now, I need Nathan to have a little bit of help on this one because he isn't good with cards. He doesn't know the difference between a club and a spade. I have no idea what the card is. We all need to keep an eye on this. And for this one, to prove that I'm not looking, because people could say, well, your eyes are open, you could have been having a look down. I'm going to blindfold myself for this one prove that I do not know where these cards are. I'll actually place out the first ones first, just so I know what I'm doing. One, two, three. Now, I will blindfold myself. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. We're nearly there, guys. We are nearly there. We're getting there. One, two, three. Final round. One, two, three. Nathan, was it in group one, two, or three?
I believe you were in two, but I need confirmation from my two friends.
I would say two in the middle.
I think I got that one, yeah.
Thank you.
Perfect. Okay.
Can you do it?
I'm nervous.
Go on.
Sweat.
I'm going to place all the cards out on the table. And Scott, we're going to bring you in for the very end. Callum, you can bring over to the side. We don't need you too close this time. Just need to watch all the cards laid out on the table. All 21 cards. We'll count them out. 3. 19, 20. Card, do you... Excuse me, Scott. Do you remember your card?
I do.
I need you, and make sure you do not say it aloud, to say it in your head 7 times. And I'm going to connect with your mind. The wand will drive me to your card. You can start now, Scott. Need it a little bit louder. Scream it, Scott, scream it for me.
Oh, is it
Nathan Rodrigo? Is this your card?
No,
the one trick pony strikes again.
No, no.
You couldn't have screamed any louder.
No. No one trick.
Let me rescue. Gran, let me rescue.
Oh, quick.
Let me rescue.
Oh my.
The problem is...
You didn't have enough cards, that's what it was.
Are you sure the Ace of Hearts was not your card?
It was a card.
What was your card?
Rodrigo.
That is because me and Rodrigo are actually working together.
Oh!
There we go!
Incredible! Incredible!
Can we let you in a little secret? We aren't actually working together. Rodrigo did actually save me there. I messed up the trick.
Oh, no!
One, two, three. Which group was it in? Was it in group one, two, or three?
Group one.
group one, this one. Are we both happy with this, Nathan, Rodrigo? That it was in group yep. one. Are we sure? Perfect.
This is Spin 103.8, fully charged with Graham and Nathan.